1968, when Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. was assassinated, Jane Elliott was the teacher of a third grade class in the town of Riceville, Iowa. Realizing that these children needed to learn a very important lesson, Elliott devised an experiment to teach them about racism and segregation and how it affects those who experience it. She divided the class into two groups, blue-eyed students and brown or non-blue-eyed students. Elliott then told the students that the blue-eyed children were cleaner, smarter, and more civilized than their brown-eyed peers. She instructed children with brown eyes to wear special colors for easier identification of their eye color. This was one of the biggest factors that influenced changes in the children's thoughts, feelings, moods, and behaviors. The participants wearing colors were not allowed to drink from the water fountain, play with the blue-eyed children, or go back for seconds at lunchtime, and various other discriminating factors. In addition to this, the blue-eyed students were treated well, while the brown-eyed students were treated as severely inferior. The brown-eyed students were also reprimanded for behaviors that the blue-eyed students weren't punished for. On the second day, the roles were reversed and blue-eyed children were made to feel inferior, while the brown-eyed ones were designated the dominant group. Jane Elliott was amazed at the speedy transformation in her class. The superior blue-eyed children became arrogant and were bossy and unpleasant to their brown-eyed classmates. The brown-eyed quickly became cowed and timid, even those that had previously dominated the class. But what really astounded Jane was the difference academically. Blue-eyed children improved their grades and managed mathematical and reading tasks that had previously proven out of their grasp, while brown-eyed high flyers stumbled over simple questions. Results from this original demonstration showed how quickly children can succumb to discriminatory behavior and how easily prejudicial attitudes can lead to frustration, broken friendships, and vicious behavior. The children with blue eyes began exercising their newfound status over the brown-eyed children with hurtful remarks. I watched what had been marvelous, cooperative, wonderful, and thoughtful children turn into nasty, vicious, discriminating little third graders in the space of 15 minutes, Jane Elliott said. On the first day of the experiment, it took the brown-eyed kids representing the minority 5.5 minutes to get through the phonics card exercise. On the second day, when they were the majority, it only took them 2.5 minutes. According to Elliott, the only change was that now they were the superior people. The kids said they were slower the day before because they had colors on. When the blue-eyed kids had colors on, they also did worse on their assignment. Those blue-eyed kids said they did worse because they were thinking about the colors they wore during the experiment. The results of the experiment with the third grade students revealed that the children adopted their roles at a profoundly frightening level. Blue-eyed students regressed to a state of insecurity while the brown-eyed students became, in Jane Elliott's words, arrogant, ugly, domineering, and overbearing white Americans. One child told the teacher that she should keep the yardstick on her desk in case the brown-eyed people get out of hand. An astonishing reaction was displayed when Jane Elliott asked two of the children why they were fighting on the playground. One young boy said, "Russell called me names and I hit him in the gut." Elliott asked, "What did he call you?" And the child responded, "Brown eyes." While processing the lesson with the children, they described how they felt and what they learned. One children said, "They don't get anything in this world because they are a different color." In one day, Jane Elliott proved that racism is a learned trait. The most important message that the experiment reveals is that children believed and trusted what their teacher told them, in much the same manner in which they believe and trust what their parents teach them. Changing the racist attitudes and behavior in the world must start with parental guidance. The belief of how other people perceive them led the participants to believe it about themselves. The kids said they felt like a dog on a leash. A most astounding comment from one child was that when he was wearing the color, he felt like he was shut up in a prison and someone threw the key away. These factors naturally occur within society on a daily basis. For example, millions of African Americans and Latino young people in the United States do not get an education equal to that of most of whites. A contributing factor to this is because urban schools they go to do not have the financial backings as do the schools in the white suburbs. This experiment showed that the children were easily persuaded into believing they were superior or inferior to those around them. When they were told certain students were better than others, prejudice, isolation, and ridicule slowly started to appear, despite the fact that many of the students would have been great friends prior to the experiment. The view of self-superiority from the students symbolizes the prejudice and discrimination that people of color experience every day. As the results of the experiment coincide with its real-world counterpart, Elliott's experiment was a success. Her goal was to teach children what prejudice and discrimination is, how it affects those involved, and how it is wrong. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a like, and if you would like to see more videos like this one, subscribe to the channel.